Hey guys, happy Friday. I'm Daniel Norton, welcome to my studio in New York. And today we're gonna talk a little bit about getting started in photography later in life. This is actually a question I get a lot. It seems like a lot of you out there are maybe this is a second career for you or something you might wanna do into retirement. And I often talk about, you know, photo groups and these kind of things. And I get the question, you know, I'm not really near people. Like, how can I start when I don't know anybody that does photography? Well, I mean, this is a tricky question because obviously it's going to depend on who you are and where you are. I'm assuming that if you are doing photography that is of not people, let's say landscapes and stuff, then this is not the person that's asking me this question because that stuff you could just obviously do. And if you want to sell it, it's easy enough just to look around for sources online that, you know, stock houses, galleries, stuff like that. You can just look for that stuff. And if that is what people want to know about, let me know in the comments because I'll make another one about that. But I'm thinking people mean they want to shoot portraits. So if you are the type of person, and this is not always true, but if you are the type of person that wants to shoot portraits or wants to shoot people, I assume that you're at least on some level outgoing. So, you know, you've got that going for you. What I will say is this. You need to let people know that you're a photographer. So you're, let's say you're, you know, in your second half of your life and you've been working as a construction worker, I mean, I don't know, or a salesman or an IT or you're a doctor, whatever. And you want to begin making portraits. Well, this is something I've said a bunch of times and I'll just say it again because I think it's true, is it's very important that you let people know that you're a photographer. Now, I've said it in the business sense that like if somebody asks you and you like stock shelves at a supermarket, but you want to be a photographer commercially, then somebody asks you, what do you do for a living? You say, well, I'm a photographer. I mean, if you're a doctor, you're probably not going to say you're a photographer if you're a doctor. You know, you just probably wouldn't, right? It wouldn't come out that way. It would come out weird. However, there's plenty of opportunities where people discuss things. And I think showing people your work is as simple as getting them to understand that you're a photographer and that you're passionate about it. How do we let people know we're passionate about something? We demonstrate it in front of them. And how do we do that as a photographer? We carry a camera with us. Now you might be thinking, well, Daniel, I want to do studio portrait photography. I don't want to just randomly walk around and take photos of things. Sure. But if you don't have a connection, you're not talking to people, you're not in a situation where you have people to photograph in your studio that you have set up, then taking the camera with you to places where people will see you with the camera and hopefully inquire is going to be one way to open that door. Here's the thing. When we are freelancers or when we are photographers or artists or however you want to say it, it's got to be always part of your life. And if you are doing this as somebody who's had a job, let's say, even if it's a career, I mean, I don't want to say it like it's a negative thing. You know, you've always been a forklift driver and, you know, you get up in the morning, you get ready, you have your coffee, you go to work, you work hard, you're good at your job. When your job is over, you go home, you wash up, you spend your free time doing whatever, photography, I guess. Being a forklift driver doesn't come up at all, right? But when you're a photographer, when you're in the arts, when you're passionate about something, it should be with you all the time. And because you are a photographer, because you're an artist and you want to share that with people, you need to let them know. And there's so many different ways. I mean, you could make a shirt that says, I'm a photographer or Bob's Photography or whatever, you know. You could do that. That would work as well. But Bob's Photography on my shirt doesn't tell people I'm a photographer. Me having a camera on my neck does. And when people ask me about it, me talking about it a bit, having an Instagram or some kind of portfolio on my phone or an iPad always with me, you know, and when the opportunity arises, even if you are somebody that likes to take a really controlled portrait, if the opportunity arises to take a simple daylight portrait, just to kind of put a smile on somebody's face or to make a connection, you do that, right? Because then when they see that picture, which might not, to you might be like, oh man, I really want to do this super, you know, have them throwing balloons in the air and dancing with sparkles or whatever, but all I could do is put them in the corner and do a nice pretty shot. To them, that's probably, if they're not used to being photographed by a professional or a very good photographer, it's gonna seem extreme. They're gonna be like, wow, this is amazing. then you reach out and say, hey, okay, this is what I can do. And I think that's the breaking point, right? Because I feel like I've talked a lot about the, okay, well, I've been talking about a few videos back about finding clients, you know, it's like you go places, you show work, but how do you get going? Like, how do you break the mold? And the way you do it is you let people know that you are a photographer. In every possible opportunity, you let people know. And it might, and I don't mean in like a pushy way, because oh, I hate people like that, but I mean just in a way that like, people are aware that you're a photographer. So people are like, oh yeah, Bob, oh, he's the photographer, right? That's right. And that's what you want to create. So hopefully that was helpful and what people are asking me when they ask that kind of thing. You know, very specific business stuff. I'm not gonna be able to do it a 5-minute video for people out there. That requires more of a one-on-one counseling. But I hope this was useful just in general. Go ahead, guys, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you next time.